Hello, and welcome to the Geek Primer. Listen to the following conversation.
Agent Carter kicks ass. She is so cool. I love a chick who could beat me up. So she's not with S.H.I.E.L.D. yet?
Of course not. The series is set before the one-shot, so she's still with the SSR.
Oh, right. This series is going to be amazing.
Oh, I thought the best thing about it was having Jarvis in it. That gives a stronger link to Iron Man.
And it wasn't fat, bald-looking Jarvis or Alfred-looking Jarvis, but young, good-looking Jarvis. Do you think we'll see him become AI Jarvis?
Tony Stark invented AI Jarvis. It's Howard Stark in Agent Carter. And Vanko gives us another link to MCU.
Cool. Maybe we'll see Nick Fury as a baby. Or his mum and dad.
In the next few minutes, you'll learn not only how to understand this conversation, but how to participate in it. The conversation is about the Marvel TV series Agent Carter, the spin-off from the Captain America movies and the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. TV series.
Agent Carter kicks ass.
Agent Carter is Peggy Carter. First seen in Captain America, the First Avenger, she was a member of SSR, the Strategic Scientific Reserve, and involved in Project Rebirth, a secret U.S. government project to create super soldiers for their World War II efforts. Their first and last success was Steve Rogers, who became Captain America. Peggy and Steve fell in love. Buddy stood her up on their first date with the excuse of crashing a plane. But they were reunited in Captain America, the Winter Soldier. In the comics, Peggy Carter was a French resistance fighter who fought alongside Captain America during World War II. After Captain America was revived in the 1960s, Peggy became Cap's lost love until he met a girl who reminded him of her. This turned out to be S.H.I.E.L.D. Agent 13, Sharon Carter, who was revealed to be Peggy's younger sister. However, as Captain America comics continued to be published, and World War II became further in the past, this was retconned so that Peggy became Sharon's aunt. Eventually, this will no doubt be further retconned so that Peggy becomes Sharon's great-aunt, or great-great-aunt, or perhaps even a past life. Now listen again.
Agent Carter kicks ass. She is so cool. I love a chick who could beat me up. So she's not with S.H.I.E.L.D. yet?
Of course not. The series is set before the one-shot, so she's still in the SSR.
Oh, right. This series is going to be amazing.
Are you beginning to understand the conversation now? The first speaker is trying to determine where the Agent Carter TV series sits within the Marvel Cinematic Universe chronology. Prior to the TV series, Agent Carter was a one-shot short movie released on the Iron Man 3 Blu-ray as a way to bridge that film with the upcoming Captain America: The Winter Soldier. In the short, Agent Carter joins the recently formed S.H.I.E.L.D. S.H.I.E.L.D. is an espionage and law enforcement agency first seen in August 1965 in Strange Tales, issue 135. The acronym stands for Supreme Headquarters International Espionage Law Enforcement Division, until 1991. Then the acronym stood for Strategic Hazard Intervention Espionage Logistics Directorate, until the Marvel movies. Now the acronym stands for Strategic Homeland Intervention Enforcement and Logistics Division. The organization's head in both comics and movies is Nick Fury. And its most persistent enemy is Hydra, a criminal organization founded after some retcon by Baron Wolfgang von Strucker. As the second speaker points out, the Agent Carter TV series is set before the one-shot short movie, so S.H.I.E.L.D. does not yet exist. SSR, the agency represented in the TV series, is, however, eventually absorbed by S.H.I.E.L.D. This portion of the conversation shows that both speakers are completely overthinking the TV series. Let's continue.
Well, I thought the best thing about it was having Jarvis in it. That gives a stronger link to Iron Man.
And it wasn't fat, bold-looking Jarvis or Alfred-looking Jarvis, but young, good-looking Jarvis.
Jarvis. Edwin Jarvis is the butler for Howard Stark in the Agent Carter series, and has been assigned by him to work with her. The first speaker is referencing the portrayal of Jarvis in the comics, where he is the butler for Tony Stark, and then the Avengers. Jarvis is usually portrayed as a stout, balding man, but as the speaker points out, some artists confuse him with another comic book manservant. Let's continue.
Do you think we'll see him become AI, Jarvis?
Tony Stark invented AI Jarvis.
AI Jarvis refers to the artificially intelligent computer system developed, as the second speaker points out, by Tony Stark to run Stark's mansion and Stark Tower, as well as providing a user interface to the Iron Man armor. The AI was named in memory of Edwin Jarvis, using an acronym that is both extremely clever and extremely dumb.
It's Howard Stark in Agent Carter. And Vanko gives us another link to MCU.
Cool! Maybe we'll see Nick Fury as a baby! Or his mum and dad!
MCU is yet another acronym in this conversation, this time referring to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Since Iron Man, each Marvel release has had links to other releases, whether via post-credit scenes teasing to the next release or references to other films. The Agent Carter TV series, as we have already pointed out, already has links to Captain America, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. TV series, and the Iron Man movies. The speakers are praising the additional links created with the appearance of Howard Stark. Howard Stark, the employer of Edwin Jarvis and father of Tony Stark, worked with the SSR on the Super Soldier project, and was involved in the founding of S.H.I.E.L.D. The speakers also reference Anton Vanko, co-creator with Stark of the arc reactor used in the Iron Man films. In comics, Anton Vanko was the Crimson Dynamo. In the films, he is the father of Ivan Vanko, who was Whiplash in Iron Man 2. Whether Agent Carter contains other links to Marvel movies or TV series is pretty darn likely. And a baby Nick Fury would not be a surprise. Now that you've heard the meaning behind many of the words and phrases used in the conversation, listen again and see how much you can now follow.
Agent Carter kicks ass. She is so cool. I love a chick who could beat me up. So she's not with S.H.I.E.L.D. yet.
Of course not. The series is set before the one-shot, so she's still in the SSR.
Oh, right. This series is going to be amazing.
Well, I thought the best thing about it was having Jarvis in it. That gives a stronger link to Iron Man.
And it wasn't fat, bold-looking Jarvis or Alfred-looking Jarvis, but young, good-looking Jarvis. Do you think we'll see him become AI Jarvis?
Tony Stark invented AI Jarvis. It's Howard Stark in Agent Carter. And Vanko gives us another link to MCU.
Cool! Maybe we'll see Nick Fury as a baby. Or his mum and dad.
Are you ready to contribute to the conversation? Don't worry if you're not. To help out, try using this contributing phrase.
So, exactly how old is she in Winter Soldier?
Good luck, and be sure to check back again for more conversations in the Geek Primer. If you have a geek topic you'd like to be primed for, enter it into the comments, and please feel free to subscribe. Goodbye. Thank you.